occupant benefit as building systems have become increasingly complex in design and operation, it's not uncommon for some building to take as long as 3 years for operation staff to settle all issues related to functional deficiencies. In many cases, that has led to unhealthy, even unsafe and uncomfortable working environment that have had a direct negative impact in productivity. Improvement in the health, safety and comfort in the working environment leads to maximizing productivity for the building occupants. Persistence of quality is a continuous commissioning programs will result in sustainable facility functionality. Continuous good working environment, increased productivity, maintaining asset value, minimizing OMM costs, enhancing public relations. In the sense of image, for whoever they got involved in building that's properly being commissioned, owners are recognized for existing quality results. Design professionals are recognized for their enhanced expertise and producing facility that meets their clients' quality and performance expectation. It is confirmed that what you design, you get. You will get what? It's only, you can confirm that only by being commissioned. Contractors are recognized for producing functionally reliable, sustainable facilities. The contractor who built the system, which the building is being commissioned, is being recognized that they are actually constructing a quality system. GBI certification is released a certification where enhanced image based on the rating awarded. You got more points, which I'm going to go through at the end of the presentation. Everybody got it, what can you see? The recognition in their promotional initiative. And equipment's more often the primary reason to commission an existing building is to reduce the consumption of electricity and utilities to optimum under all modes of operation. Another reason is to correct condition that is negatively affecting the occupants with regards to their safety, health, or their negatively affecting comfort, or their specific activity, all of which are seriously impacting productivity. Commissioning of this building has proven to be profitable return on investment activity. Commissioning the existing building allows the owner to correct undesirable condition that likely had plagued occupants or users since the building was originally occupied. Indoor air quality issues, for example, are quickly resolved through commissioning. You have situation where some designs, same issue. There are certain places that is cool, there are certain places that is not really. So they adjusted the dampers and everything, but it's not happening. I think it makes sense, huh? It's happening everywhere. So where is the problem? Commissioning existing buildings establish optimal operating procedure for all conditions, those models of operation procedure that likely will never optimize during occupancy. Commissioning results are reliable for sustainable operation and also provide evaluation procedures that can be applied to aging system. Commissioning documentations include recommissioning plan that makes it easy for operation staff to maintain and fine-tune the system. And some people say, don't I already pay for that? Yeah. You know what, never mind. So design professional agreement doesn't allow for third set of eyes, as per commissioning is doing. Doesn't allow for quality control beyond field of observations. May not have the same level of field experience. Construction contract, CX requirements not specified. Doesn't require formal CX program, doesn't include performance criteria, doesn't include witness tests, not a condition of for final acceptance. Typical project configuration since 1970, this is actually more or less, you can see that nowadays it's actually more, you have more and more sectors, people who get involved in these things, and the issue is that improper coordination leads to, this building is actually complete, but we have problems. Yeah? So commissioning helps actually to fill up the gaps, to coordinate everybody to work together. Commissioning encompasses all some people say that we are trying to take over the job done by the architect. So this is actually the concept of trend estates, and people who do the same design, they monitor it. So it's a conflict of interest. You cannot monitor, you cannot actually verify the job that you did. Designed by you, you need to bring somebody else down. Somebody else to do that. Make sense? So it's that sense has been implemented for many years, resulting in very good building elsewhere. How does commissioning help? Set a clear measurement goal for everyone, verify owner requirements, establish accountability, chances to be people perform, allow designer contractor to measure success. That's where they have to measure success. Prevent and resolve problems, designer focus on owner. We have a start to see issues for them for 5-6 years. I come to know, for example, they got very big success for their own implementation of commissioning in cabbage rate. And I know this is actually basically a very new field over here, and it's very clear that commissioning nowadays, you know, we are going to talk about it starting from pre-design stage. So it's totally new school of thought. It's time to be, you know, absorbed and digested by you guys. So that's why I go through the benefits. So I'm going to go through, run through the approaches, you know, which I believe you need another proper course to go through and the steps to be taken to commission a proper building, which is quite tedious and quite complicated, which you will see. But the process can be done, let me handle by the commissioning people. But I believe there's a lot of owners, you know, building owners here, which actually can consider, you know, if you would like to confirm. You know, you get what you pay for. This is the only way. This is not the better way. Approaches new construction, pre-design through competency, existing building, retro commissioning, in existing uncommissioned buildings. You never commissioned before, so you want to do it, yeah? You want to confirm what kind of quality of system that you have now, you can do a retro commissioning. And for previously commissioned buildings, you have to do you can do re-commissioning. Specification of GPI, I think that's for 3 years, things like that. So you have to do re-specification after 3 years. So you basically, I believe for existing building, you must offer me all the data that you have to do and commissioning this part. Alright, I've got another 5 minutes. You have a system to decommission building and the mechanical system like HVAC, piping, all these things, electrical systems, specialty systems. And this is the process, pre-design, design, construction, acceptance, quality. Commissioning is not just testing at the end. And at the pre-design, what we do is that scope of CX, proposal, contract, budget, select, or commissioning specialist, OPR, prelim CX plan, system manual requirements, pre-design, you know, this is done by the commissioners. Yeah? Design stage review basis of design, refine CX scope specification, design phase CX meeting training requirements, all this in it. We have time to read all going. Yeah, construction stage. We make sure that construction plan is made, and so that we form a construction commissioning for construction team. Commissioning team for the construction. Construction key off routines and details, site observation, inspection. And I would like to highlight this, that everything is actually, all issues is actually being noted in the issue logs. The issue log is actually a very, very important document by the commissions to ensure that anything that highlighted issues that been raised can actually be resolved, or at the end of the day, when we hand over of system being commissioning with some unsatisfactory area in issues actually, but it's been noted that okay, it's been commissioned by this group, we had the first place we present, we will never get the certificate. It's been noted, and unless the owner accept it, basically they accept it with the, you know, the situation was being noted. Yeah, so that's the way. So pre-functional test, we have to conduct the pre-functional test, field inspection verification, you do site observation, you know, you ensure that installation is correct. This is very simple, like for example, when they purchase an issue, then they need a reheat coil over there. And this is the reheat, this is the coil, this is the cooling coil, this is the reheat coil. How the maintenance people going to reach the coil completely? You're going to disassemble the heating coil, it's not going to work. So this is the commissioner's work, you know. When, as simple as when you do the commissioning process, you have an issue installed in the plant room. You don't have enough area to open the door, even. The door is, you know, the accessibility. Like we can name a lot of it. How in the world that you're going to maintain it? This system is not forever, it's life. I can name a system that, you know, the reducing valve at the top of the ceiling, nicely done, faster ceiling. We need to commission this thing, and we have to climb up, and how are we going to put our weight over there? And how are we going to monitor your steam system supply for hospital, for example, your water system, pressure system, without proper metering located at the right place? And this is the situation that needs a third eye to look at. Yeah. A simple thing that make a lot of difference for you to run the building, because the contractors, even the designer, is not going to be there right after it's being handed over to you. Right? So you need a quality building that, you know, you can have time as the owner. Even like, for example, a JKR or anybody, you will not have time to really go through all this thing. But you cannot ask a people that having a conflict of interest, like architect. This is fact. I have to, there must be architect over here, but this is fact, you know, this is recognized worldwide. This must be a party that doesn't involve with any design stage to ask questions from the early stage. Why you do this? Why you design like that? You know, this is what I've been trained for, is that you start the meeting with that, you know, we're going to run this meeting, you know, but I'm going to ask a question, a lot of questions. If you are going to be very helpful, you're going to be, you know, we're going to initiate very fast and going to write reports on the design. But my job is to ask questions. And the redesigner actually raised the answer, why actually the loop calculation is based on this? Have you considered the part loop for the air conditioning system? Do you know that most of the time you are running air conditioning system at part load conditions? You are not running at a full load. What happened to the control valve? What happened to the fresh air that is introduced coming in? You know about the mold coming in, all these things? Why? High humidity. GBI, green building tells you that you have to design something that having a low humidity below 70% RH without any additional dehumidifiers whatsoever. And with all due respect, for example, to our friends over there on the solar technology, things like that. You know, you have this 35 and 40 degree of solar capability to do that. A CX people will be like, for example, ask you that, for example, how are we going to take care of Legionella? The potential outbreak of the water of the Legionella disease or bacteria. Because our normal design standard says that you have to design hot water centralized system at minimum of 60, you distribute at 60. And a best practice design saying that you will actually need a thermostat to control to get whatever temperature that you're actually running at related location, like for example, magnetic ward on this thing. The CX, we ask this question whenever, you know, that's why the experienced CX commissioner, we ask this thing. Because you need to distribute the hot water system, because it's going around, you know, going around, it's there, it's a storage design. And normally it's you have the instantaneous, but you still store inside the piping and you don't want it to have, because bacteria basically stop breeding at around 60 degrees Celsius. And we know that it's like, for example, commercial temperature. So it is good to achieve, to take baths, to everything at around 35, but it cannot distribute within too low than 60 degrees Celsius. This is study done. That, you know, we need to justify, but if you're really taking care of the Legionella by somebody else, somebody like this, no problem. So this is it. We'll ask questions, and you need the designer, we need them to conform so that the user will get everything what you want. For example, construction.